Hello everyone, hope you all are doing well. So welcome back again to my channel Science and History. This is Sneha. So my previous video was on freshwater ecosystem and type of freshwater ecosystem as we discussed. Now this video is all about aquatic macrophytes or larger plants of the littoral zone. Yeah, it's about the plant which grows in littoral zone. So let's go. So first of all, a brief introduction of littoral zone. Littoral zone adjoins the shore and extends down to a point called the light compensation level, or the depth at which the rate of photosynthesis equals the rate of respiration. Within the littoral zone, producers are of two main types, rooted or benthic plants and phytoplankton or floating green plants, which are mostly algae. Aquatic macrophytes of the littoral zone are mainly of two types. First is aquatic macrophyte that attach to the substratum, which are emergent macrophytes, floating leaf macrophytes or submerged macrophytes. And second is freely floating macrophyte. Now some basic points about aquatic macrophytes of the littoral zone. Habitat classification of aquatic macrophytes in any inquiry into the botanical aspects of lakes separate from the phytoplankton, one is confronted with an array of rather arbitrary definition of the sessile flora or aquatic system. Many definitions are based on reproductive characteristics in relation to the aquatic stages in the life tree of groups of angiosperms. From a strictly botanical viewpoint, such a definition are quite satisfactory. From an ecological standpoint, however, such species-oriented categorizations are unrealistic and ignore major system interrelationships. Alternatively, words such as hydrophytes are ambiguous, even though the term hydrophyte generally refers to vascular aquatic plants, it can include any form of aquatic plants. The term aquatic macrophyte, and it is commonly used, including in this work, refers to a microscopic form of aquatic vegetation and encompasses microalgae, the few species of mosses and ferns adapted to the aquatic habitat, as well as true angiosperms. Division on the basis of size is admittedly also arbitrary, but as discussed further on, when combined with the definition of the attached macroflora, it permits a meaningful separation of primary producer in the littoral zone. Now coming on type first, aquatic macrophytes attached to the substratum. Now emergent macrophytes. These plants occur on water-saturated or submerged soils from the point at which the water table is about 0.5 m below the soil surface to where the sediment is covered with approximately 1.5 meter of water. They are primarily rhizomatous or chromous perennials. Some of their examples are Glaceria, Alocabris, Pugmites, Scirpus, Typha and Dejania. Now moving on, point 2. Floating leaf macrophytes. These aquatic plants are primarily angiosperms that occur attached to submerged sediments at water depths from about 0.5 to 3 meter. In hydrophilous species, submerged leaves precede and accompany the floating leaves. Reproductive organs are floating or aerial. Floating leaves are no long flexible petioles. Their examples are the water lily snuffer and nymphaea, or on short petioles from long ascending stems. Now third, submerged macrophytes. These plants comprises a few pterophytes that are quilvert acids, numerous mosses and chaophytes that are stonewort algae, Cara, Nitella, and many angiosperms. They occur at all depths within the photic zone, but vascular angiosperms occur only to about 10 meters. Leaf morphology is highly variable from finely divided to broad. Reproductive organs are aerial, floating, or submerged. Now coming on point 2 or type 2 freely floating macrophytes. An extremely diverse group, freely floating macrophytes are typically not rooted to the substratum but live unattached within or upon the water. They are diverse in form and habitat, ranging from large plants with rosettes of aerial and floating leaves and well-developed submerged roots. The examples are Aconia, Trapa, and Hydrocharis. Two minute surface floating or submerged plants with few or no roots that are Laminaceae, Azolla, and Salvinia. Reproductive organs are floated or aerial but rarely submerged are listed here. So that's all for the video. Thank you.